Hello and welcome to session 17, Exploring Copilot and Power BI. I'm Andrew Conniff, a Microsoft technical trainer specializing in data and AI. And today we will explore the journey of data analyst in Power BI. Let's dive right in. In this session, we'll discuss understanding semantic model requirements for Copilot, creating visuals and reports using Copilot for Power BI, and creating summaries using Copilot for Power BI. We can use Copilot to create measures based on natural language or update our semantic model with synonyms, which will improve the user experience in the Q&A or to generate report content. We can summarize visuals and pages from propagated prompts or from pre-populated prompts. We can also analyze the summary of a semantic model. Copilot works with our semantic model. It's important then to have a very good model relationships and a clean data set. This will allow us to work with Copilot to build reports and understand our data and add visuals that summarize our data. There are four views in the Power BI desktop: the report view, the table view, the model view, and the DAX query view. We can select Copilot from the ribbon and then use natural language to describe what we want. So consider the following prompt: total sales for all salespeople individually for all items in the accessory category. This prompt is intended to calculate each individual salesperson's total sales for the accessories category. Use Copilot Index Query View to explore the data and determine which measures we need to create, and then select Update Model with changes to create the measure. The query on the screen was generated from a suggested measures prompt. The screenshot is a result of three steps: entering the suggested measures prompt and selecting Keep Query after the results were returned, and then running the query. The Copilot experience is consistent with other Microsoft Copilot products. Select the Copilot button and a new pane opens with suggested prompts and chat capabilities. Some of the prompts you can try are create a new report page, suggest content for a new report page, or answer this data question, then insert your question in the chat. The following example was generated by using the create a new report page suggested prompt. Copilot asked for the name and description and then created the report elements, including the header with slicers for product and salesperson, card visuals for the sums of sales and cost, and measures for profit, sales minus cost. Area charts evaluating sales and cost and profits over time. Column charts evaluating sales, cost, and profit by product. And a map visual for sales by region. Copilot also provides several suggested prompts based on your semantic model. For this example, we see several different possibilities offered, including sales performance by salesperson, regional sales analysis, product cost and profitability. In the screenshot, we selected the product cost and profitability prompt to generate a new report page. This page has a similar layout from the one created with the Power BI desktop. There are card visuals, bar and column charts, and area charts to help analyze the cost and profitability of different products, including standard cost, profit, and profit margin. Summaries in the report keep the audience engaged by providing a clear and concise overview. We can create summaries with the narrative visual. The narrative visual allows us to create a custom visual that summarizes and references data within our report visuals. Custom narratives give more control over formatting and text. Copilot created summaries include the following suggested prompts: give an executive summary, answer likely questions from leadership, and create a bulleted list of insights. Now let's go to a demonstration and see what this looks like in Power BI. To use Copilot in Power BI desktop, the first thing we have to have is capacity. So here we have a Copilot capacity. This is just my name for it. You could name yours whatever you want to. I find that when creating Fabric, we don't always have Copilot included in our capacity because the level of capacity is different, the price is different. So this, I'm putting some sort of marker in here to let me know that this is the one. When I'm not using it, I'm going to pause it. It's meant to be used for whole organizations, not just one individual demonstration. So we've turned this on. And the next step is to create a Fabric workspace and then connect it to that capacity. So we would come in here and we'll see I have a Copilot
workspace created, and it has some items from our Power BI desktop that we have published here. And to go back through the steps that I did to get here, I had an admin come in and create this page, so new workspaces, and gave it the name. Under the advanced tab, selected fabric capacity. And when you select this, a dropdown opens up, and any fabric capacity level artifacts that you have in Azure, you can connect to. So you choose the one that you connect, keeping the names very similar. And then I have this fabric level workspace. The capacity is on, the workspace is live, and in Power BI, we have our report that we've been working with. And I published my report and semantic model to that workspace. When I open Copilot, it prompts me also to connect to that workspace. So now that we're all connected and Copilot works, I can ask it about new report pages. I can say, suggest content for a new report or answer some questions about the data. So I think we'll try suggest content for a new report page. So it's going to look at what we've done and come up with some ideas. So here's like sales by region, distribution. I kind of like that one. Let's try that. All right, now we can see that we have map and filled map are not available for our organization. They have been turned on, that hasn't filtered through yet. And we can try sales performance. So very similar to the overview page. And my report page works as expected. And from here, I can change what I may want to have for my visuals. And of course, many of these don't make any sense. It seems to have definitely chosen a very good visual. Now in the Copilot view on the page, I could just start typing, this is my DAX editing, so I could put in my own processes, but I can also ask Copilot. So I could say, create a measure that filters all the sales into bins of time for each month. All right, so here we have sales binned by month, and it's come up with it. So we have to choose keep it if we want to keep it. Then of course we can run this query. We'll see here we have the bins of sales by month. You can also say suggest measures, right? And we can, if we keep that query, we can then run it and let's see which one it is. So what it's saying to do is sales profit by quarter, sales total sales by region, and average profit per order, and then sales total sales by region are the results. And so we can peruse through this. And if we want to then update the model with our changes, we add that measure. So we have seen how to write DAX to help us get items for visuals. So let's update this. And now in our visual page, we have additional measures that we can use in our visualizations. That brings us to the end of our demonstration of Copilot in Power BI.
This concludes our session. There are many ways to continue your learning journey, and we encourage you to watch other videos in this course or search out your next favorite topic on Microsoft Learn at aka.ms/learn.